Wish a buck was still silver. It was back when the country was strong.
I like 16-foot gates. I had this 12-foot gate that I bought for a fence job, and they backed out, so I had to eat this gate. So I'm going to use this gate here. This is going to be a 16-foot wide alley, but I came in a little bit off of here to put my gate. It'll be good. We're going to hang the gate on that post there. It's going to swing back in. This side's going to go in and straight down to the road crossing. So anyway, I'm going to show you. I've hung dozens and dozens and dozens of these darn gates. I like these gates. They come from pasture management in North Carolina. I like these gates. They're galvanized inside and out. And I can show you gates that I put up in 2000 that look just as good as the one I'm fixing to hang now. So anyway, hang with me and we'll get this done. I use a 4-foot level to line up with my gate hinge post. If your gate post ain't exactly straight, this eliminates any problem. And then because 12-foot gates are bad enough, a 16-foot gate is nearly impossible to wrestle by yourself. So I use these little clamps and hook it on the bucket of the tractor and let the tractor pick it up and move it over to where I need it. It works out really, really good, and you can get it level. So the little ratchets hold it up. You put your magnetic level on it, and then all you have to do is go click, click, click to them ratchet clamps and get it level. It works out really good, and it's real easy on you, and you can do it by yourself. You don't need three people to wrestle a gate. So this works out really good. You just ratchet it up until it's aligned. Now you want to mark where your hinges are going to go on the vertical line that you made with the 4-foot level. Keep in mind that top hinge is pointed down and the bottom hinge is pointed up. That way somebody can't lift your gate up and swing it and get into your pasture or whatever. So you want to be sure to do that. You need a good set of channel locks to put these hinges on, because those suckers are tough. You got to really squeeze it to get it on and put the nut on. And you got to do the same thing at the bottom. It's a pretty tight squeeze with them channel locks, but it's the only way I know to do it. Now, once you've got the hinges on, we marked where our vertical line is, and then we mark the horizontal line where these holes are going to be. I like a DeWalt drill, and I like a ship auger to bore these holes. It works really good. You can get them at Lowe's. And we're still level. Now you want to tighten these up and keep that bubble in the middle. When everything goes right, it don't take too long. Sure our hinges are nice and tight. And as you can see, we're right in the bubble.
Remove your ratchet clamps from the bucket and the gate.
I don't know if you can see or not. There's a little hole right here in these hinges, and that's where this little self-tapping screw goes. And what that does is, if this ever loosens up, it won't let it slide around in the post.
Without the screw, that hinge may loosen up and it'll drop down off of the hinge bolt, and then your gate is just flop-sided up there.
The best of the free life is still yet to come.